Welcome to the Micro Zoo, where you'll find the smallest creatures that have ever existed. From a pint-sized elephant to a baseball-sized single-celled organism. Wow, how does that happen? Anyway, don't touch anything. Some of these pipsqueaks can compete with the most formidable hunters out there. The smallest elephant is the Borneo pygmy. They're about 7 feet tall, which doesn't sound teeny, but remember, African elephants could get almost twice that at 13 feet. An interesting fact, the pygmy elephant's tail can get so long that it drags on the ground as they walk. Not a teeny tail. Another diminutive member among this planet's giants, the dwarf sperm whale could easily be mistaken for a dolphin. It usually grows about 7 feet long. Compare that to the world's largest whale and animal overall, the blue whale. It's over 10 times longer. Cuvier's dwarf caiman is the puniest member of the crocodilians. When full grown, they get only about 4 feet long, 4 times smaller than the saltwater or American croc. But this itty-bitty buddy is no pet. He's a ferocious carnivore that hunts and is rarely hunted. Among human species, it'll be Homo florensis. Adults grew no longer than the average 4-year-old boy today, 3.5 feet, and their hobbit-like skulls were only about as big as a grapefruit. The rusty spotted cat is here to represent the world's littlest wildcat species. It's about 15 inches long and weighs a measly 3 pounds. That's way smaller than most house cats. And yes, people do domesticate these playful mini-kitties, though they are wild and probably prefer their natural habitat. Then you've got the dwarf lantern shark, coming in at 8 inches in length, which is slightly longer than a pencil. It looks like a baby, but this creature is full grown. But the coolest thing is that it feeds on krill and can emit light. The most petite house cat on record was a Himalayan Persian. His name was Tinker Toy, and he was only 7 inches long. This full-grown miniature kitty could easily fit in your palm. The littlest cat breed overall is the Singapura. A brown chihuahua named Millie from Puerto Rico is the world's smallest dog, according to the Guinness records. She's just under 4 inches tall, about the height of a soda can. Chihuahuas are also the runts among all dog breeds in general. The dinkiest dinosaur was a 5-inch-long bird-like creature found in a pebble-sized piece of amber. It looks a lot like a hummingbird, only its beak is lined with sharp teeth. The smallest snake could easily be confused with an earthworm. At just 4 inches in length, slightly longer than a credit card, it belongs to a newly discovered species called thread snakes. Like worms, they mostly live underground. But as snakes, these little guys are meat eaters and feed on termites and ants. For primates, there's Bertha's mouse lemur. It lives only in Madagascar and is 3.5 inches long. It could swing on your finger like a tree branch. They don't hibernate in winter like other lemur species. The pygmy possum is 3 inches long, a little bigger than your thumb. In winter, the possum rolls into a tight ball, closes its eyes with its ears, and goes into temporary hibernation. The pygmy gerboa is an itsy-bitsy 2-inch-long rodent with a tail 5 times longer than its body. It looks like a cross between a tiny kangaroo and a mouse. You could easily confuse the bee hummingbird with a flying insect, thanks to its size. This crumb is about 2 inches long, the size of a golf tee. But they're still hardy and agile. By the way, hummingbirds are the only birds that can fly backwards. The Etruscan shrew, length between 1.5 and 2 inches. Eatsy, but with a good appetite. This creature eats twice its weight in food every day. Yet a tree can be about the same size. There's an unusual forest along the coast of the North Atlantic. Because of the strong Arctic winds, all the vegetation grows teeny tiny here to protect itself from the bitter cold. Within this mini forest, you can find the dwarf willow, the smallest tree species. Its height is only 2 inches, but it has wide leaves 1/2 inch in size to maximize the absorption of sunlight. The most miniature of all mammals is the 1-inch-long bumblebee bat. The name is enough to get the message. Its body is about the size of a large bumblebee. The dinkiest reptile in the world is the Rokisia microchameleon from Madagascar. It's about 1 inch in size, and it's got plenty of room sitting on the head of a matchstick. The littlest octopus in the world is the octopus wolfie. It's less than an inch long and could sit comfortably on a penny with room for its friends. Compare that to the Pacific giant octopus, which usually gets 20 feet long and weighs over 100 pounds. Yep, he's well-armed. The pea crab is the minutest of its family. Measuring half an inch across, these pea-sized crustaceans like to hang out in oysters and mussels. The smallest amphibian, and the teensiest of all vertebrates, is half the length of an aspirin, just a third of an inch long. It's a frog native to Papua New Guinea. Two of these specks will fit on your nail. The tiniest known fish in the world is the stout infant fish. It's just over a quarter of an inch long. It has transparent skin and no scales or teeth. The world's smallest scorpion gets no bigger than a quarter of an inch in length. By the way, 3 inches is the size of the most venomous species, the Indian red scorpion. But the smallest venomous creature in the world is the Irukandji jellyfish. It's less than a quarter of an inch long, like the head of a Q-tip. This little guy's almost impossible to spot in the water, but its venom is as dangerous as a cobra bite. Here's another pint-sized nightmare inducer, the Patudigua spider. It's so itty-bitty that you could easily miss it sitting right there on the tip of your finger. It's a third of a millimeter long, because inches just won't cut it at this point. And that's the width of just 4 pieces of paper stacked. However, there's a unique small creature that could probably withstand any jellyfish, scorpion, or spider venom. I'm talking about tardigrades, or water bears. These microscopic invertebrates, half a millimeter in size, are the most resilient creatures on the planet. They can be frozen, scorched, and even survive in outer space. Fairy wasps are the world's minutest insects. Measuring just 0.14 millimeters, they're as long as a sheet of paper is thick. You could line up almost 100 of them on the width of your pinky finger. Now, entering the microscopic world. These tiny things are everywhere – in the atmosphere, the depths of the ocean, in glaciers, and of course, on and in our body – bacteria. Just one, well-washed, apple contains more than 100 million microbes. If you could squish them together, they'd be the size of a grain of sugar. In the human body, there are tens of trillions of bacteria, or about 3 pounds worth. Don't worry, they're supposed to be there. And even among teeny-tiny bacteria, there are ones considered smaller than normal. So microscopic, it's like it doesn't exist at all. 150,000 of these bacteria will fit on the tip of a human hair. The same number will fit on the largest bacterium that can be seen with the bare eye. Now, there are some creatures that are 10 times tinier than those ultra-pint-sized bacteria. It's called the nanobe. This thing is so small that scientists still debate whether to consider it a living organism. The nanobe is only 20 nanometers in size. You need to divide 1 inch into about 40 billion parts to get 1 nanometer. All bacteria are microscopic single-celled organisms, but there is one type you can hold in your hand and clearly see. It's no bacteria, but it is single-celled – bubble algae. Also known as sailor's eyeballs – yuck! This little green ball of algae is a little smaller than a baseball. It's difficult to study these organisms because they're so fragile. But we do know that they help process water in the ocean and produce useful nutrients. So, was that small enough for you? Well, good! Hey, if you learned something new today, then give the video a like and share it with a friend. And here are some other cool videos I think you'll enjoy. Just click to the left or right, and remember, stay on the bright side of life.